You got idiots in every profession. You got idiots that are coaches. You got idiots that are television people. And one idiot can ruin for the whole bunch.
Ooh, but hey, guess the truth hurts sometimes. In any event, the majority of coaches don't view the press as the enemy.
I really believe that the media attention for our kids in particular is good.
My job is to promote my team and my players.
I'm the kind of guy that I like to trust people until they prove me wrong.
Gag orders and media blackouts not altogether uncommon, though rarely successful. For example, 2002, Ron Zook silences Florida team before their clash against Florida State, only to lose 31-14.
If I go out there and you know, shut all you guys down to our practice and they know that's never happened, and then, you know, it might make things bigger than they need to be.
In other words, talk is cheap.
I don't think you guys coming in an interview has anything to do with the outcome of a game.
I think what you do Monday through Thursday is way more important than all the stuff you can say on Friday.
Still, coaches are envious of their pro counterparts, the Nick Sabans, Greg Popoviches of the world, who routinely chastise and condescend to the media throng.
You know, you take Belichick, nobody, I mean, he doesn't like it. He hates it. He don't want to be in front of the camera at all, but I love watching it.
You know, of course, everybody's going to remember Oklahoma State, what's his name?
Come after me! I'm a man! I'm 40!
Gundy called me about a player probably 3 weeks after that happened, you know. And that's one of the first things I said, Coach, I'm just going to say I appreciate you standing up for your player. And we had a five-minute conversation about that whole deal.
All that said, bulletin board material can make an impact. In 2006, then-Kosciuszko head coach John Perry had someone imitate then-Louisville head coach Brad Peterson insulting the Whippet program.
They talked about how Kosciuszko went tough and all this, and he played it to him before the game and threw the thing down and broke it into pieces. I think he had to buy his daughter a new, you know, tape thing after that.
I lost my daughter's jam box on one of them because I broke it as we went out the door. So we played really good and really hard. So, you know, maybe I need to break some more jam boxes.